When I first started out this game, I was a bit skeptical. I mean, for the first 2 hours or so, except for one of the most unique boss encounters I experienced, the friggin' Hydra, it just felt like a generic hack and slash platformer that tried to be epic by being ridiculously gory and featuring music that was way too over the top. You know, you get the whole, oh, or a lot of chanting kind of orchestra background music. So, it just felt kind of like, it's trying too much, but I'm not feeling it. The first few puzzles I encountered didn't impress me, and the story progressed really rather slowly. For those first 2 or 3 hours of gameplay, I would be lying if I told you guys I wasn't a bit bored. But after that, the game quickly kind of redeemed itself for me. I came to realize that this isn't just a typical button masher. Sure, the game's inspirations from Devil May Cry was extremely easy to notice, but the different combat moves and style had me completely thrilled. The enemy AI wasn't impressive compared to the likes of Ninja Gaiden, but regardless, the enemy design and the methods required in killing them were just awesome. The brutal nature of Kratos is hard to just not be appealed to. Surrounded by gorgeous graphics and swallowed into an incredible story premise of a Greek mythology tale turned upside down, I found myself with my jaws dropped, my shoulder leaning forward toward the TV screen, my fingers quickly working combos of glorified awesomeness. The combat, of course, didn't start becoming fun until after I figured out a few puzzles here and there. Some were laughably easy and perhaps a bit unnecessary, but most of them were pretty damn unique and fun to do. The magical powers you came to obtain and the ability to upgrade your sword as well as your magical abilities only enhanced the fun experience I was having. And just as I was able to claim the game as repetitive or boring, a cutscene would pop up, and I would soon just be immersed into the incredibly well thought out storyline of this anti-hero protagonist named Kratos, and his quest to kill Ares, the Greek god of war. What I can say is that I just ended up loving the game. I mean, the music did get annoying a few times, and some levels were poorly made, actually, but the overall awesomeness of the experience made me consider all of my criticism as just nitpicking. I would still like to mention two little nitpickings. One very minor thing that annoyed me was that when the game just had these level segments where all you did was walk from one area to the other, usually across really long bridges or climbing up stairs after stairs, it just felt like the developer saying, "Hey, look, our games look graphically awesome and we're forcing you to marvel at our awesome programming talents." Every time I encountered such areas, I couldn't help but feel that the developers of this game were just being a bit too arrogant. But you know what? The graphics are actually pretty damn amazing, so I guess they have a reason to be a bit arrogant. The second thing I didn't like about this game was the level Hades. In that level, there's a segment where you have to climb up these rotating cylinders covered in spikes. As you climb up those cylinders, if you hit any of the spikes, just barely, you'll fall all the way down and you'll have to start climbing that thing from the very beginning all over again. Considering the fact that these cylinders are ridiculously tall, getting past these cylinders was a tedious and frustrating experience. Like I said, that's just, you know, nitpicking. The game's awesomeness makes me forgive those tiny flaws, at least when considering the game as an overall whole. I'm prone to forgiving these aspects, especially when considering the fact that the game is loaded with tons of content. The game is not just over once you beat the game. I mean, I admit that the game doesn't have an extremely strong replay value, but there are loads of content to unlock from trailers, to behind-the-scenes developer videos, to costumes and whatnot. Besides, the game is just awesome, so I think it'd be hard for people who fell in love with the game like me that could refuse to play the game again at a much harder difficulty. After beating this game 2 times, I think I could definitely understand why this game is loved and adored by most Sony fans who played it. It's just an amazing game, and if you haven't played it, well, you really, really should. Check out the awesome level design, awesome graphics, and just awesome storytelling where you actually get to learn why Kratos' skin is so damn pale white.